And I'm Ariana, and welcome to the Wilson Buzz.
Heavily armed gunmen stormed a newspaper office and killed 12 people. The masked attackers reportedly hijacked a car and sped off, running over pedestrians and shooting at officers. Two police officers were shot and killed. Four people were critically injured.
Did you know a former Miami Dolphins player, Robert Conrad, fell from his boat off the coast of Florida and swam 9 miles to shore and to safety? The boat was an auto-piloted and drifted away from him when he was fishing offshore. He fell from his boat off the coast of Florida near Palm Beach when his friends noticed Conrad was overboard. They contacted authorities. The Coast Guard of Palm Beach Coast Sheriff's Officer searched for him for an hour. The Palm Beach County Sheriff's Officer located him on the beach around 4:40 a.m. in Palm Beach.
And now off to Destiny.
A father was accused of throwing a girl over a bridge and had police run-ins. The girl was 5 years old and was attended kindergarten. The name of the girl is Phoebe Johncheck. The police are wondering why he threw a girl over a bridge. The fall was 62 feet into Panama Bay.
Hi, I'm Jared.
And I'm Gabe.
And I'm Jordan.
And we're here with the local news.
To start off with, a new drug is used to try and stop Ebola. It is being tested at a Liberian hospital. However, it's not so new to the doctors and nurses that work at the Nebraska Biocontainment Unit. Early testing has shown that the drug really does work. Doctors don't know if it is possible to make an effect on humans. They will be testing the new drug on 140 new patients.
In December, parents of kids ages 4 to 1 and 1 reported kids missing after allowed to go on a 2-week trip to Colorado with their aunt and uncle and were gone over a month. Council Bluffs police found documentation showing the parents gave temporary rights to the aunt and uncle and the children are safe. The children are safe and now are investigating with Child Protective Services to figure out the best living situation for the children. For Next Story.
A man was hospitalized in a critical condition after a fight led to gunfire in Omaha Sunday morning. 35-year-old Zentino told the police he'd been in a fight near 84th and F Street. The fight resumed around 2:30 a.m. The suspect pulled a gun and shot Zentino, but luckily Zentino was able to take the gun away from him. And right after that, the cops were called 25 minutes later about a robbery, and it seemed to be the same guy who shot Zentino.
And that's all we have for the local news. See you next time, Wilson.
Oh, hi, I'm Chloe.
And I'm Amber.
And I'm Angel, and we're here for the weather for today and this week.
On Monday, January 19th, it will be a high of 47 degrees, partly cloudy.
Looks like it's getting warmer, am I right, Chloe?
Yeah.
On Tuesday, January 20th, it will be a high of 39 degrees, partly cloudy.
On Wednesday, January 21st, it will be a high of 36 degrees with 50% chance of snow showers.
On Thursday, January 22nd, it will be a high of 32 degrees, mostly sunny.
On Friday, January 23rd, it will be a high of 35 degrees, partly cloudy.
On Saturday, January 21st, it will be a high of 23 degrees, partly cloudy.
On Sunday, January 25th, it will be a high of 38 degrees, partly cloudy.
And that is all for the weather.
Have a great day, Wilson.
Hi, my name is Cameron, and here are some NCAA teams that could win the trophy. And the Duke's Blue Devils are 14-0, and the NCAA and the Virginia Calivers are 14-0, just the same. They have a chance of winning the trophy for NCAA, and now to the NFL for Harley.
Hi, I'm Harley, and I'm going to tell you about the teams that are close to the Super Bowl. The teams are the Patriots, the Colts, the Seahawks, and the Packers. The team with the greatest odds of winning are the Seahawks, with odds of 117 to 100.
Hi, I'm Matt, and I'm here at the NBA Scores of the Week. The Pelicans had a game against the Hornets. It was a close game. It was 94-98, and that was at the Hornets Stadium. And in the Rockets versus the Cavaliers, the Rockets won. It was 93-105. That was at the Cavs' house. Also, the Lakers versus the Clippers, and the Clippers won 114-89. That was at the Lakers' house. Funny fact, the Lakers and the Clippers share the same stadium. That's it for the NBA sports scores. Now to Campbell.
And that's it for the Wilson Buzz Sports.
Hi, my name is Alex.
And I'm Leon.
We're here to tell you about the lunch menu. First up, today we'll be having, Tuesday, January 20th, we'll be having burrito with cheese sauce, a corn dog, yogurt and bagel, tossed salad, refried beans, and peaches and fresh fruit.
Wednesday, January 21st, we'll be having chili, cinnamon bun, chicken filet, yogurt bagel, tater tots, and cucumbers and a fruit cocktail.
Thursday, January 22nd, we'll have barbecue, pork, an egg roll, yogurt and breadstick, broccoli and cheese sauce, pears and fresh fruit.
Friday, January 23rd, we'll be having mini French toast and sausage, turkey, cheese turkey, yogurt bagel, carrot zucchini, and celery sticks and juice.
And that's it for the lunch menu. Stay tuned.
Hi, I'm Chloe.
Hi, I'm Jacob.
Hi, I'm DQ, and this is this week's school announcements.
Every Friday from 3 to 4:30, you can be in the Cliff Cove making some food on the 3rd, on the 9th through the 30th.
If you want to know how to sew, learn how to on Thursday from now to February 26th. It is from 3 o'clock to 4:30 p.m.
To 12 students can explore inexpensive snacks. You can make them. You can do this from now to January 28th on Wednesday.
Do you enjoy playing video games? Join this club to learn about video games and challenge one another in some competition on January 14th to March 4th, Wednesdays from 3 to 4:30 p.m.
And this is this week's school announcements. I'm DQ.
I'm Chloe.
And I'm Jacob.
Hi, I'm Sunny.
I'm Allison.
I'm Destiny.
And we are here to talk about movie reviews. The first movie we want to talk about is Taken 3.
Last week on January 9th, the final chapter of Taken was released.
Liam Neeson is back for the final chapter of Taken. The director is Oliver Megington. Enjoy this action adventure available now.
Taken 3 has come out. When Brian Prince's ex-wife brutally murdered, he is accused of the horrible crime. He then flees the site with the CIA and FBI right behind him, now trying to take care of the last thing important in his life, his daughter. How will he get out of the crisis?
The other movie we're going to talk about today is Paddington.
Paddington comes out on January 16th and is now available in AMC theaters.
From the producer of Harry Potter, Paddington is a family comedy that meets a bear at a train station. The director is Paul King.
A young Peruvian bear travels to London in search of a home. Finding himself lost and alone at Paddington Station, he meets the kindly brown family who offer him a temporary haven.
And that's all for the Wilson movie reviews.
Hello, I'm Gage.
And hello, I'm Jesse, and we're here with what's on TV.
Mike and Molly will be on CBS.
Mike and Molly is about the relationship of teacher Molly Flynn and Chicago police officer Mike Biggies, who fall in love when they meet in overeaters' relationship anonymous meetings.
On Tuesday, January 20th, the Cleveland show will be on tune to 8 p.m. to 9 p.m., and Lester says he'll kill himself after losing his life savings and investment. Rollo opens a barber shop in the kitchen because he's tired of having his haircut by his mom. Guest voices include Michael Stipe of R.E.M. So that's it for what's on TV by Wilson.
I'm Brian.
I'm Dakota, and we're here with top two TV shows of the week. Here's Brian with Agent Peggy Carter.
After the end of World War II, Agent Peggy Carter is pushing paper at the Strategic Scientific Reserve while secretly helping clear Howard Stark's name. With the assistance of his butler, Edwin Jarvis, in the drama based on the Marvel one-shot short film of the same name. When troops return from fighting abroad, Peggy Carter finds herself marginalized once again by 1940s U.S. society. In the wake of losing her love, Steve Rogers, she struggles to find balance between navigating life as a single woman and working at the CSSR. With administrative duties and tackling two commissions for an old acquaintance, Howard Stark, Edwin Jarvis, Stark's butler, helps Carter as she risks her life and freedom to complete assignments. Now here's Dakota with the Nation.
3 years since the zombie virus swept America, there's only one person known to have survived the infection. His name is Alvin Bernard, a.k.a. Murphy. The world's last hope at creating a vaccine, the last functioning viral lab, needs blood from him for its antibodies. But the facility is in California, and the man is in New York. A ragtag group of strangers works to transport him to the West Coast, but they don't know about his dark secret, which could threaten all Hammond, and his second-in-command, Garnett. Lead the group of the living, and computer hacker Citizen Z helps everyone navigate the zombie-infested terrain. The one leading them to the facility in California is Citizen Z. The main character is Z Nation are Doc, Murphy, Cassandra, Roberta, Addie, Mac, 10K, Citizen Z.
I'm Brian.
I'm Dakota. And that's all for top two TV shows of the week.
Peace out, people.
Hello, Wilson. I'm Jalen.
And I'm Haley.
And this is our second episode of Celebrity Gossip.
Jake Bell, past actor on Drake and Josh, music career is in jeopardy. Jake was in his brother's pool party while he dove into the water and didn't realize how shallow the pool was.
He shattered his wrist by crushing it on the concrete on the bottom of the pool. He had surgery on his wrist, and after the doctors broke the devastating news to him, he will never be able to play the guitar ever again.
Chris Brown may be getting locked up again. There has been many violations and red flags during his probation, such as he has gotten locked up twice while on probation and has been at two nightclubs while there were shootings. Will Chris Brown get locked up?
Paris Hilton spends $25,000 on two baby Pomeranians, then gives one puppy to her mom for the 35th anniversary gift.
Jamie Lynn Spears' little sister Brittany was at a restaurant eating right before it closed as a group of guys got into an argument that escalated quickly and Jamie had to break it up with a knife.
And that's it for our celebrity gossip of the week.
Hey, this is Erica.
And Aaliyah with the top 10 songs of the week. Starting at the bottom of the Billboard, from number 8 to number 10 is Animals by Maroon 5.
From number 10 to 9 is Jealous by Nick Jonas.
From number 6 to number 8 is I'm Not the Only One by Sam Smith.
From number 9 to 7 is Shake It Off by Taylor Swift.
From number 5 to number 6 is We Have All About That Bass by Meghan Trainor.
From number 4 to 5 is Lips Are Moving by Meghan Trainor.
From number 7 to number 4 is Thinking Out Loud by Ed Sheeran.
Still at number 3 is Take Me to Church by His Horizer.
From number 1 to number 2 is Blank Space by Taylor Swift.
And finally at number 1 is
Uptown Funk by Mark Reason featuring Bruno Mars.
And that's all for the top 10 countdown Billboard.
My name is Jacob.
And I'm Dylan.
And we're here with the Athlete of the Week. This week we will be talking about Marshawn Lynch.
He currently plays for the Seattle Seahawks as a running back.
In his first year being on the Seattle Seahawks, he made 12 rushes, touchdown.
In his old years, he could only get up to 8, which means he got put with a great quarterback.
And this year, Marshawn Lynch has 13 rushing touchdowns this year, so we can tell he is better off with the Seahawks.
And this is all for the Sports Athlete of the Week.
Hi, I'm Brittany.
And I'm Ashay.
And I'm Breeza.
And we are here with the top actress of the week, which is Scarlett Johansson.
She was the only girl to be the top star in action movie in 2014.
She was born November 22, 1984.
She is a model, singer, and actress.
She has a baby with Ryan Reynolds. She premiered in the movie The Avengers, Bee Bada Zoo, Iron Man 2, The Nanny Diaries, SpongeBob SquarePants the Movie, Ghost World, Home Alone, Lucy, and much more.
Sofia Coppola's Lost in Translation 2003, for which she won a BAFTA Award Best Actress in a Leading Role.
Roles in A Love Song by Bobby Long and Woody Allen's Match Point earned Johansson 2 more Golden Globe Award nominations.
She makes about $20 million.
She was nominated for the Independent Spirit Award for Best Female Lead for her performance in Many and Low.
I'm Brittany.
I'm Breeza.
And I'm O'Shea. Have a nice day, Wilson.
Hi, my name is Trey, and we are here with the Wilson Video Games. We are beginning our story with the top console of 2014. PS4 beat out Xbox One, 3DS, and Wii U. The top-selling games that were sold in 2014 at number one, Pokemon Omega Ruby and Sapphire, selling 6,498,601. At number two, FIFA 15 selling 5,302,438. At number three is Call of Duty Advanced Warfare selling 5,252,150 copies. And last but not least, number four is GTA 5 with 4,725,624 sold. This is all we have for the video games of this week. Tune in to next time for another video games update.
I'm Trevor.
And I'm Raymond.
I'm Zach.
And we're going to be talking about Good Game Empire. The game is at empire.goodgamestudios.com. This game is a medieval or classic game.
Once you get on and make your name, password, and type your email.
You start in a tutorial, and once you've finished it, you can begin playing.
The goal of the game is to take land over and get max money to upgrade defenses.
Basically, you build up an empire, and when you feel like you're ready, you can battle someone else's empire.
This game is somewhat like the game Clash of Clans and has a similar idea.
I'm Trevor.
And I'm Raymond.
And I'm Zach.
And this was the online game of the week.
Welcome to the History of Technology.
Hi, we're Lexi Fisher.
Stephanie Haluza.
And Nick Camacho.
And my name's Rihanna.
The first cell phone was made 30 years ago from the day Martin Cooper changed the world when he made the first cell phone call 40 years ago. Business applications, gaming and photography, mobile phones that offer these and more general computing capabilities are referred to as smartphones.
Cooper remains a revered figure in cell phone history. He had another moment to shine. Motorola's resort event.
Cell phone division largely has been swallowed up by Google, which now demands the instruction that has all internal mobile systems.
A mobile phone, also known as a cellular cell phone and phone, are simply a phone.
In addition to modern mobile phones, also support a wide variety of other services such as texting, messaging, MMS, email, internet access, short-range wireless communication business.
That's it for the history of technology.
Hi, I'm Blake.
I'm Jordan.
And I'm Skylar.
And last week we talked about the Brown Box. Now this week we're going to talk about the Odyssey and the Palm.
The second game system was the Odyssey. The Magvox Odyssey was the world's first commercial home video game console. It was the first demonstrated in April 1972 and released in August of that year.
The third game system, Pong. Pong was one of the first video games to reach mainstream popularity. The aim is defeat an opponent in similarity table tennis game and earning a higher score. The game was originally manufactured by Atari Incorporated, which released in 1972. Alan Corey Pong as a train device.
Have a great day, and that's all for this week. Have a great day.
Hi, Wilson.
We're Alyssa,
Kason,
and Rachel. We will be telling you about FaceQ, Tumblr, and Pinterest.
The first step is FaceQ. FaceQ is an app where you create a stylish avatar that looks like you. You can put it as your profile picture for any social media, website, or app. FaceQ was created on September 21st of 2014. The app was made by Myanta team. This app is free on the Android and Apple stores now.
Tumblr is a microblogging platform and social networking website founded by David Karp and owned by Yahoo. The service allows users to post multimedia and other content to a short blog. Users can follow other users' blogs as well as make their own blogs private. Much of the website's features are accessed from the dashboard interface, where the option to post content or post up followed blogs appear. As of January 1st, 2015, Tumblr hosts over 2.16 million. The final app dashboard interface, where the option to post content or post up followed blogs appear. As of January 1st, 2015, Tumblr hosts over 2.16 million. The final app is Pinterest. In this app, you can share pictures and add other people's pictures to an album of yours. Ben Silberman, Paul Sciarra, and Evan Sharp made this happen. Pinterest was launched in March 2010. In February of 2013, there was reported to be 48.7 million users. In May of 2014, it was valued to be $5 billion. This app is free and available to download on Android and Apple phones. This concludes Apps of the Week. We are Alyssa,
Kason,
and Rachel. We hope you download some of these apps.
Hello, I'm Sam.
I'm Tori.
And I'm Alexis.
And we're here with the Apps of the Week. And we're talking about movie apps. Crackle is an online distributor of television quality original web shows, Hollywood movies, and TV shows. Founded in the early 2000s as Grouper and rebranded in 2007. Crackle is backed by Sony Pictures Entertainment. Crackle is free. It is for iPhone, iPads, and Androids.
Have you heard of Netflix?
Yeah, I watched The Fosters. It is awesome. I'm on season 2, episode 3.
Yeah, Netflix is awesome. I watch My Little Pony every day after I get home.
Both of you shush.
Sorry, Sam. I just can't stop thinking about Rainbow Dash and Fluttershy. They're my favorites. So is Princess Luna.
And I can't stop thinking about Brandon Foster.
So true. Okay, so back to the point. If you're lazy and have popcorn laying around your house, have someone microwave your popcorn for you and watch some episodes of your favorite TV show or watch your favorite movie. Netflix is a provider of online internet streaming media available to viewers all around North America, South America, and parts of Europe. And now Alexis with Crunchyroll.
Crunchyroll is a free app you can get on your phone or any electrical device. You can watch anime TV shows off this app pretty much anywhere. You can watch any anime shows such as Naruto and Sailor Moon Crystal.
And that's all for the Apps of the Week.
Have a good day, Wilson.
Welcome back, Wilson. I'm Madison. Hope you had a happy new year.
And I'm Giselle Martinez. Hope you had a great Christmas.
And I'm Alexis, here to tell you about the national days of the week from the 19th to the 23rd.
On the 19th, National Popcorn Day, Martin Luther King Jr. Day, which is the third Monday in January.
On the 20th is National Butter Crunch Day and National Disc Jockey Day. Disc Jockey Day is about celebrating the hardworking entertainers that brought energy to the dance floor across the globe.
On the 21st, National Honey Day, National Granola Bar Day, Squirrel Appreciation Day. On the 22nd, National Blonde Brownie Day. It was first known as Blonde Brownies and later just Blondies. Chocolate-free, butterscotch brownie were all the rage in the mid-1950s. Today, a blondie might be the classical butterscotch treat or maybe another cocoa free bar.
On the 23rd, National Pie Day, National Handwriting Day.
And this has been the National Days of the Week. Have a great day, Wilson.
See you next week.
Good afternoon, Wilson. Today we'll be talking about the Mexican culture. This time we're going to talk about a celebration that takes place each year in the Mexican culture, and then to the food, then we go to the clothes.
Hi, my name is Juan, and I'm here to talk about Cinco de Mayo. Cinco de Mayo is celebrated to celebrate their independence. Most people like light up fireworks in Mexico. They celebrate a big carnival in their country. We celebrate it in Omaha. They make a big fair and have rides and fun things to do and enjoy with your family. That's it for the Mexican celebrations. And up next, we go to your Mexican food.
Hey, my name is Carlos, and if you want to be in the Mexican tradition, you should dress like you're in the Mexican tradition. Most kids there in Mexico like to dress like their parents whenever they can. Men wear tailored pants, loose fitting, and held up with a wide belt. Mexican clothes are all in strong color and beauty, craftsmanship. That's all for the Mexican way.
Hoy voy a hablarles sobre las comidas mexicanas que son tradiciones en México, como los tacos, los tamales y el pozole.
Thanks for tuning in, Wilson. Thanks, and tune in next week. Talk about more Mexican culture.
Welcome back, guys. I'm Joel Cooley. Welcome to Disaster of the Week. Today's disaster will not be a ship disaster. Today, I will talk to you about the world's deadliest terrorist attack. I'm going to tell you about the September 11 attacks, also known as 9/11, on 8:42 a.m. American airliner spot yet been crashed right into the North Tower of the World Trade Center. And later on 9:03 a.m. United Airlines Flight 175 crashed into the South Tower of the World Trade Center. But the impact site went lower than the North Tower, trapping more people. Then after that, in 9:33 a.m., American Airlines Flight 77 crashed into the Pentagon in Washington, D.C. Then earlier, another aircraft caught United Airlines Flight 93 begins its hijacking journey on 8:42 a.m. On 9:59 a.m., the South Tower of the World Trade Center collapsed, damaging the Marriott Hotel nearby. Then on 5:20 and 27 seconds, the Building 7 begins to collapse. Then, and 7 seconds later, it collapsed completely. So years later, the site has been cleaning up to build a new World Trade Center. By 2006, 7 World Trade Center reopens. Then on the 10th anniversary of 9/11, the 9/11 Memorial opens. Then on 2013 and 2014, World Trade Center reopens. Following that, the 9/11 Museum opens and World Trade Center reopens. Then on 2015 and 2017, the Transportation Hub opens and World Trade Center reopens. By 2020, the site rebuilding will be. That's it for the disaster of the week.
Hi, I'm Ryan here with the history of the week. In 1519, it was the 100th year of war. In 1947, the KTLA was the first TV station. In 1984, the first Apple Macintosh computer and mouse was made. In 1986, Martin Luther King Day became the holiday. 2002, Kmart became the biggest retailer in the United States. And that's all for History of the Week.
Hi, I'm Nathaniel.
I'm Thomas.
I'm Cameron.
And we're here with
the On the Right
and On the Wrong.
Hey, can you stop running?
You're not my boss!
Don't stand under icicles.
Home fires happen more in winter seasons than any other season.
Snow, sleet, and ice can lead to hazards, road conditions. Listen, students, tell your parents.
And now off to Officer Height.
Hi everybody, this is Officer Height, and I'm giving you a weekly installment of the safety tips that I feel are very important that you all should know and adhere to. What I'm going to talk about this week is throwing snowballs here on school property, on any public property, is technically against the law. Throwing a snowball falls under throwing missiles. It's throwing missiles on street, at a vehicle, or on property is unlawful. It shall be unlawful for any person in the city to throw any stone, stick, brickbat, wood, snowball, or other substance at any person in or upon any street, avenue, alley, or any public place, or any city bus. What that basically says that if you're here at school, after school, waiting for the bus, the snow stays on the ground. We don't pick it up, we don't throw it at each other. That way we don't have the possibility of a person getting injured. Sometimes those snowballs you make might pack a little ice in them. If you hit somebody with it, they could get injured. Also, the fact that you throw a snowball at somebody, they throw one back at you, and before you know it, we have a fight on our hands. So with the snow on the ground right now, and then probably more to come down here, in the near future, make sure when you're outside that the snow stays on the ground and not in your hands. Thank you.
Hello, Wilson. I'm Gracie.
And I'm Jacob.
And I'm Lindsay, and this is Joke of the Week. Why does Humpty Dumpty love autumn?
Why?
Because Humpty Dumpty had a great fall.
How do you make a tissue dance?
put a little boogie in it.
What did the green grape say to the purple grape?
What?
Breathe, stupid.
Because when you hold your breath, you turn purple, and the grape was purple.
Why is that? Why is it that your nose runs, but your feet smell?
What does a nosy pepper do? Gets jalapeno business.
What do you call a deer with no eyes? I have no idea.
This has been Joke of the Week.
Goodbye, Wilson.
We're going to Starbucks.
Yay.
Thank you for watching the Wilson Buzz.
Have a great day, Wilson.